Hello everyone, it's Thursday, June 10th, 2021. I just arrived at the entrance of the Canadian-Australian embassy. I sent them an email this morning, so I'm not going to go down in order to speak with anybody because you know how it is. This is the public area, as you could see here. I'm going to open my banner and we'll be sitting here. I will also tweet at them, hoping to see somebody from the Australian embassy in order to find a resolution to my dire situation in this country. So I'm so very exhausted. Yesterday was raining yesterday evening and everywhere was wet. You know that I'm staying during the night at the National Library of Greece, where I am charging my phone and my computer and doing my computer works. I also sleep there in the bushes. I haven't made any videos on that, but I will when the time is right. So for the time being, I'm going to open my banner. I will continue to be here and see what is going to happen. So here we are already here, police. Hello, they are already here, police.
I speak to you.
Yes, I'm listening.
Yes.
Well, I'm here. I send an email. This guy knows. Send an email this morning to the Australian embassy. I wish to speak with them. I have this banner. I'm going to open it up. Here is the public area. And I will be going to stay here until I speak with somebody from the embassy or I don't know.
You're not going
find
to speak.
A, find a solution to my situation.
You cannot speak with anyone. You know that.
So yeah, okay. No, I don't know that. So that's how it is. This is my banner, and this is the Australian embassy over there. This is the police. As you saw, they are already calling the police. So I will be waiting here to see what is going to happen. It's a public area, and I'm trying to collect some signatures for my online petition. That's all. And of course, find a solution to my their situation. Police arrived already in less than 10 minutes. And the refugee trying to find help for his life. Can't find it in 7 years. Only dealing with the police. Yes, I speak English. I don't know Greek.
You don't know Greek. Come to me. Tell me something.
Sorry?
Come to me. Tell me something.
Yes.
You have any problem in that? You have to record with your cell phone?
Yes. Because I fear for my life.
From who? From me?
From everybody. Yes, including the police.
Okay. What do you need here? What do you want?
Well, I already informed the... I already informed these people. I also informed... I'm actually here for the Australian embassy.
Okay.
I sent them an email this morning.
They told you that you can't travel to Australia, right?
Who told me? Who told you? Who told you?
Why you come here?
You sent me something now. Who told you that I cannot travel to Australia?
You signed some papers? To travel to the Australia?
Yes, I'm asking for resettlement. Asylum.
Asylum?
Yes.
You don't sign for asylum here. You know where to go to for the asylum?
Asylum in Australia, not in Greece. I have these documents from Greece. I've been robbed here. I've been robbed by this country.
You don't have to take from here. Take it from here. My face, you can record from here, not like this.
I want myself to be in.
Too. Okay.
As you can see here, I've been on protest in front of the office of the United Nations Refugee Agency.
Απλώς διαμαρτύρει την πρεσβεία, δεν μπορεί να παραβρίσει το χώρο.
Έχει κάνει χαρτιά για να φύγει η Αυστραλία.
Και τα έχουν απορρίψει 100 φορές.
Έχει
απορριφθεί 100 φορές. Και αυτό επιμένει να είναι εδώ.
As you can see from here, I have been protesting in front of the office of the United Nations Refugee Agency, which is of course is the responsible agency to solve my problem. But they are not solving my problem. I had a shelter there, they destroyed all my shelter with the police. They took all my clothes, my belongings, my phone. Now I have to go from embassy to embassy and ask them to help. What else do I have to do? I mean, I have no other choice.
Go to the asylum at Philoxenou Street and make a report from the...
They are aware. I've been to the minister's office 2 weeks ago. I have been writing to the minister's office.
Listen to me now. Anyone who can come here for any asylum or anything he wants, if you don't take what you want, you don't have to stay here. You can't stay here.
I am here on protest, and I am also collecting,
I don't care for this post.
I am also here collecting signatures for my petition.
You can't stay here.
It is a public area. Why I can't stay here? It is a public area, isn't it?
Go to the police station to check your ID.
Yeah,
I don't have a computer. Come with me.
It's a public area, isn't it?
Okay, I want your paper.
This is the paper I have.
They don't have any photo of you. I don't have any computer.
You have a copy of my identification in the other, inside.
Find it.
It's the last one, here.
We don't need photocopy, we need the original. Yeah.
With pictures.
Yes, we need the original. I need the original, not photocopy.
I don't have, they are expired.
It's not
they are not valid anymore.
Listen to me.
And this is the public area.
Follow us to the police car. We will go to the police station.
To check your ID.
Check your ID. Okay, come with us.
I need 1 minute.
What?
I need 1 minute to collect this.
What? Yes. Collect it.
Yes.
You go in every embassy with this.
Yes, of course.
Start with it.
Sorry?
Start.
Yeah.
Mother, my friend, we don't have time.
You don't have time, and you are killing me. You have time for killing refugees, but you don't have time
listen
for,
to me.
For
if you have any if you have any problem with me, you can
you
me.
Don't
okay.
have time for us
Take
to
this
do
and
let,
go.
You don't have time to let us find the help for ourselves.
Listen to me.
Yes.
Make it quick, because this police car is not only for you. It's for 5 million people living here in Greece.
Yeah, Mr. Policeman, okay. But you know that you are here for no reason.
Packing.
I'm in the public area.
Start packing.
I'm in the public area.
Start packing.
You are already here for no reason, actually. This is harassment.
Okay.
Public area,
start,
peaceful,
start
peaceful,
start
assemb- peaceful
start
assembly.
Packing.
Yeah, okay, give me 1 minute. No, I was in front of UNHCR's office, the police destroyed my shelter.
Okay. Listen to me, by the time that you're getting inside of the police car, I'm not giving you the permission to film me or my colleague.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. I recorded until there. Where do you want me to put this stuff?
Inside with you. If you want to be safe, listen to me.
Yes.
If you want to be safe, record for last the ID of the patrol.
Yes.
Okay.
I will. Just let me put this stuff inside, please.
Because inside we have some situation, you can't record it.
No. I won't record inside.
My friend, listen to me.
I won't record inside.
Listen to me.
Yes.
This is a patrol.
Yes.
Inside we have some situation.
I do not record.
Some orders.
Yes, okay. I do not record inside.
I don't record. If you want to be safe for your life, record the plate number before you get inside.
Yeah,
and
okay.
You close yourself.
Here is the plate number. Okay.
Okay, close.
At the Australian embassy, they called the police again. Immediately, the police arrived in 10 minutes, maybe even 5 minutes. You saw how early they arrived. They brought me here to the Syntagma Police Station again. There was one police officer here, very fascist. Obviously they put me in detention, but before they did that, he was punching me in my head. Then inside there was a canopy inside that I wanted to lay down on it. And then he comes again, and then he starts attacking me there, kicking my legs. So basically I was assaulted on 3 counts station today. That's what these people do to refugees, and then they tell me, you don't go back there. So they helped me, I think, about for 2 hours. Now it's almost 2. I could go back to the Australian embassy, but it will be the same story. And since I haven't slept last night because of the rain, as I mentioned earlier, I will have to go, I don't know, find somewhere to get some rest. And also, of course, find some time to edit and publish these videos of my efforts today. 7 years, nearly 7 years of continued efforts to find asylum in a country, compassionate country, that I would be respected, that I would be welcomed here. That's how it is. For nearly 7 years, if you can believe it, they robbed me of everything. I'm now reliant on other people's donations for my very survival. They destroyed my shelter in front of UNHCR. Same people who claim to be helping and standing with refugees. Now I'm without shelter. Without shelter. Without food and without money. A beneficiary of international protection. That's what they do to us. They brought all the miseries of the world upon us, and all I'm dealing with is the police, being assaulted by the police. I have made so many complaints to the Greek ombudsman for these continued assaults. But I mean, they do this all on purpose. Then they are all in it together, because the Greek ombudsman also is not investigating my complaints, and the attacks, assaults continues, because I'm trying to find a legal way, resettlement. That's what is happening every time, and also not reporting on my situation, none of the press, none of the media. So I will call. I'm appealing again to your sense of humanity, wherever you are. If you are watching this or reading this post, please go sign my online petition. If you can, also please make a donation. And this to be continued. I look forward to your solidarity and support in whatever way is possible. Take care. Bye.